Are you ready?
Bada boom, Realist Podcast is in the room. Welcome to the Max Wrestling Podcast, part of the VOC Nation Radio Network. I am the most epic host, Darcy Dangerously, and you can't teach that. Happy SummerSlam Day to all, and of course, we're fresh off the heels of last night's NXT TakeOver, but we won't be talking about it just in case you haven't seen it yet, because obviously it was on late, and SummerSlam's on late tonight, so you might want to stay up, so I don't know. We're not going to spoil it for anyone. Now, we do have plenty to talk about, though, as we prepare for the four-hour party, so let me introduce this week's teams. As usual, captain of the blue team is the podcast Phenom. Prepare for the rise of the Phoenix.
Howdy doody, everybody.
Howdy doody, and who's joining the Phoenix this week?
Just a sec.
You forgot who it is?
No, the... no, it's the intro, it's the... intro that I'd lost.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, it's making his Max Wrestling Podcast his return. He bleeds blue, so it's only right he's on the blue team. It's Mike Chadwick.
And we're gonna lose again.
So. Well, you might do if he forgets who you are. And there are... go on.
If he forgets to hack.
I don't hack.
I proved don't hack. He lost.
I don't know how to hack.
Well, on the red team is the red captain. Sorry, the red team captain. Captain of Blood Red Money. It is, of course, Mr. Uncensored, Evan Makeba.
I told my daughter, if you wank, you'll go blind. You're talking to a plant, Dad. I'm actually over the other side of the corner. And she's told me.
last week it was challenge accepted.
Yeah, no.
Obviously, you accepted the challenge.
Yes. this is. I'm on some Doctor Who shit. I travel into the future, and I'm actually blind.
It only took a week.
Yeah, time travel.
I even tried to hook him up with Sonny last night.
Please tell me you didn't fail at that, surely.
No, mission successful.
Oh, good. Was it sunny side up?
Yes, and milky side down.
Looking at the pictures, it's sunny side down. Jesus Christ.
Oh, I still need to find her porn stuff with a vivid video. Mm. I'm intrigued about that now.
I'm guessing it'll be on something like Craigslist. And as you heard, also on the red team is the host of Offshoot Radio and also co-running the Swerve Talk Network with us. It is Mr. James Belmont on Pigeon Patrol 24/7.
I'm going to smash a guitar if it don't leave his head.
Guitars.
That's all I've got to say. I'm so salty. Three games in, 2 points. I'm just done at the moment.
Football.
Move on.
Move on quickly. Alright, so as we said, we've got plenty to talk about, and I will come back to Swerve Talk in just a moment. But first of all, check out our free current issue at maxwrestlingmag.weebly.com. You can buy our new t-shirts at maxwrestlingshop.com. And don't forget to visit our main site, maxwrestling.wix.com/maxwrestling. And if you want more info on the upcoming Swerve Talk Network featuring us, of course, Max Wrestling, along with Offshoot Radio and Sunday Segway and many more, follow us on the Swerve Talk on the Twitter machines.
That evil Twitter machine.
Yes, it's... speaking of takeover, it takes over your life. Now we're going to get a quick word from our sponsors at VOC Nation. We will be back with This Week in Wrestling History and, of course, this week's topic, Tron. So don't go anywhere and don't forget to use the hashtag MaxWrestlingPodcast.
Hey, guys, remember when WCW was awesome?
Remember when WCW was on?
I do. I was there. So relive the memories with us, good, bad, or indifferent, for WCW Retro. Myself.
And sometimes me.
And sometimes Derek. We'll have a different topic every show about our favorite wrestling company, WCW.
Call in and join us, too. You can share the memories with us.
WCW Retro.
Right here on the VOC Nation Radio Network.
The most polarizing personalities worldwide. This is the VOC Nation Radio Network.
And we're back. So let's find out what's been happening this week in wrestling history with the Phoenix.
Okay, SummerSlam 2004. Randy Orton found the World Heavyweight Championship after it disappeared at WrestleMania 20.
Found.
Now, the thing is, are we sure that it disappeared or did WWE Vacant take that? Was it
I'm going to go with Vacant.
Vacant made the run-in.
How long did Vacant hold it for? 4 months?
Let's see.
Because I think WrestleMania was in March that year, wasn't it? So about five months.
Five months.
Stop changing the fucking month that WrestleMania's on. It's bad enough. We had 3 pay-per-views in, 6 weeks, a couple of months ago? Okay, now pay-per-view overkill. Okay, what else has been this? What else has been happening this week in wrestling history? I haven't even started drinking yet. Fucking hell.
August 16th, 2010. Sheamus beat Zack Ryder in 11 seconds, the fastest WWE title match in Raw history.
I'm glad it wasn't the Daniel Bryan match anymore.
That's 18 seconds, wasn't it?
Zack Ryder, yeah. Zack Ryder, now he's tagging with Mojo Rawley.
Get hyped about it, man. Get hyped.
He fucking irritates me.
Yeah.
So slowly but surely, a lot of people in NXT are getting on my nerves.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but I'm watching NXT just going, I don't like you, I don't like you, you shouldn't be wrestling, your gimmick sucks.
You're so salty over this Tottenham thing, aren't you?
So salty, man. So salty, believe.
Any more history this week?
In the first in-ring match for 11 years, Stephanie McMahon defeated Brie Bella last year at SummerSlam.
Shit. I'm joking. That's not one of the questions. I'm joking.
she was so over as well. That was a great match.
Good
pedigree, nice. Too.
That was nice for a moment to see a Bella over. Never again.
I think most of the history this week are going to be from SummerSlam. So
we've got more. Okay. Well, It's only fitting. SummerSlam is tonight.
Can I just point out that Nikki Bella hasn't defended the title for over a month and still hasn't relinquished it yet?
You can damn sure point it out because I am definitely going to be ranting about that in a few moments.
You cannot imagine the profanity going through my head at the moment.
Oh, yes. Vintage WWE changing the rules as they see fit. Because fuck logic.
Logic?
What's that?
What's logic? Go ahead with the history.
SummerSlam 1996. Mankind beat The Undertaker in the first ever Boiler Room Brawl. That'll be one of the questions now.
No, but I do need to be careful because there is one question about a SummerSlam. Any more history, dare I ask?
SummerSlam 2001, The Rock beat Booker T to win the WCW title for the first time.
And that's the most excited I've ever seen Big Show. That's also the fastest I've seen him jump off a chair. What else has been happening?
Lita beat Stephanie to win a women's title in the first women's main event on Raw.
Was that the first time Lita won it?
I think so.
I thought she won it off Trish the first time. I'll have to check.
I can't remember.
Phoenix, use Google like you usually do. Just look it up.
I think it might have been Stephanie, actually, because I don't think Trish won it for the first time until Survivor Series.
Good point.
Yeah, and...
Yeah, all right, fair enough.
Check your history, boy. Any more?
Make me. No, that's it for this week.
Okay, that's going to wrap it up. Let's go to the Topictron. As usual, there's 5 topics to choose from, and I've sorted out a little bit of an order now. So, guest of the blue team goes first. Mike, pick a number between 1 and 5.
Number 1.
Number 1. First topic this week is Speak Owens Speak. Which is basically Kevin Owens' promo when he owned the fans on NXT this week. Basically calling him sheep. He had a good point.
Did he just sum up the Bella fan base for that?
Yeah. Yeah, I think he also called them idiots.
Yeah, sorry, I haven't got one.
He's been in my eyes since he debuted on NXT last year. Was it last year or this year? It just seems he's been like on this fucking whirlwind.
Yeah,
By far, that is the best promo I've ever heard him. I mean, it's up there with WWE Vacant's Pipe Bomb. It's that good in my eyes.
It's up there with Female Vacant's Pipe Bomb Shell as well. Who is actually just been shown in the trailer for the Madden movie.
Yeah, what the hell was going on in that trailer? Seriously. It's just
I have
the most
no
random
idea. It sort of
thing
popped out of nowhere.
Wait, did he say Madden? As in, like, NFL Madden?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What? Why?
I don't know.
We'll be getting
right, okay. I'm an American football fan, but why?
Why was there a T-Rex at the end?
We'll be getting a FIFA movie in a couple of years as well, now where the ball just passes through the net.
I'm not trolling. I'm being dead serious. I saw it last night, just going, what on earth is going on?
Oh my god, this is some crackle shit. What the fuck is this?
I don't know. I had to check the scotch I was drinking and all sorts. I don't know.
I have to check what I'm vaping.
That's Rob Van Dam, isn't it?
Yeah. He has been
tweeting. No, proper 420 blazes it.
He's been tweeting 420 a lot lately. It's not even April.
Max Wrestling 420.
420
24/7. Well, maybe he's been smoking since April. And he
doesn't know what day it is. He thinks it's still
slow motion. So to us, it's August, but to him, it's about around about 2 o'clock in the afternoon in April on the 20th.
Okay. So Kevin Owens obviously nailed down an awesome promo. And of course, we saw Finn Balor sitting on the corner after the lights came back on. Nice little setup for their match, which you may or may have not seen last night to take over, depending if you've seen it yet or not. Obviously, we're not going to spoil it for you. Okay, let's get another topic going. Guest on the red team, which is James Belmont. 1, 2, 3, or 4? No, we've had 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5.
We got 5.
5. Kick in the Brock.
I'm so done with Taker at this point. I'm so done with this whole thing. Can you please go away?
I don't know what he's doing. Is he a heel?
Exactly.
He keeps showing up and kicking Brock in the bollocks.
There is one thing that annoys me about this, is that they've given Brock basically no momentum into this match.
No, he's got beaten down every time. Yeah. Well, except the brawl where he got taken away. But apart from that, he's been kicked in the nuts, choked fair.
To be fair, he's been kicked in the nuts every time.
It's a complete reversal from last time.
This is what I'm thinking now. Obviously, they have the phase of please nerf. Now I kind of feel like the WWE is taking that literally. And the only way that you can nerf Brock Lesnar is kicking him repeatedly in the bollocks. I remember Chris Jericho for WrestleTalk TV saying that if he had to wrestle Brock, he'd actually spend, you know, that 10, 15 minutes kicking him in the bollocks. It appears that they've heard that and they've heard what I've said. And they said, you know what? Yeah, okay, we can do that to nerf Brock. And that's what's happening right now.
Taker should have just watched Extreme Rules 2012, because apparently all it takes to beat Brock Lesnar is an AA.
And a chain to the head.
Chain fist to the face.
And AA and that silver fucking chain on his hand.
The thing I don't like is that the sudden weakness hasn't been done at a steady pace. He's just a complete shadow of what he was after Mania.
Yeah, I would concur with that. And I think that's the problem with schedules. I mean, yeah, they're part time and stuff, but we have not seen enough of either of them, other than that startup. I mean, it's a huge match anyway, so I'll be excited for it. But there's no meat to the story. It's just Lesnar comes out, takes a kick in the bollocks, and that's it. Every 2 weeks,
chokes him,
it's like signing on. You sign on a doll to be kicked in the bollocks.
Yeah, they had that massive brawl, which was fucking awesome, and they just they've gone downhill since then.
Because the thing is, it's all been backwards anyway, because the timing was wrong. Why do it? Was it a Battleground, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That was one of the stupidest things I've ever seen.
Yeah, if he wanted revenge, they were there in the same building at WrestleMania. Why didn't he just cost Brock the title?
And then hasn't Seth Mania been and anyway? Gone? Exactly. Why don't you just do it then and then go from there? Why wait months after and then suddenly think, do you know what? We're going to do this now. So, no one cares anymore. Well, if you do, I'll be surprised, but no one cares. The streak's been broken. There's nothing else to do. He's just doing it just to get his win back or something.
Yeah, exactly. And we've said this on a couple of episodes ago. If or when Taker does win, it's just going to cancel out Brock ending the streak anyway.
This is some Hulk Hogan booking shit.
This is Hulk Hogan booking, brother.
The thing is, though, is that Lesnar, although, yeah, he would have broken the streak, and he hasn't lost since, but he can't remain undefeated forever. And then who do you really think could give him that first loss since beating the streak?
Well, here's the thing. Taker's never beat Brock. So what's he going to do now? Beat him when he can barely hit two moves?
Well, the thing of Taker.
That's a good point.
The thing of Taker, I don't seem to be harsh on him, but they're making him look weak because the only time he can get him down is kicking him between the legs. Yeah. And he might do that at SummerSlam just to get the win. So I'm not sure trying to get him healed or anything.
You can't really kick him in the bollocks at SummerSlam because then he'll get disqualified, because as far as I know, no disqualification match.
It's very late for a heel turn, I'll just say that much.
I don't think the heel turn would work anyway. He's too respected now, isn't he? Otherwise, he would have been heel after he buried Paul's bear in cement. But he was still a face after that, so...
Well, the same thing happened, the same setup with Shawn Michaels. He never beat Michaels going into that match at Mania, and then he ends up beating him twice on the spin. So I'll just leave that there. I reckon he's going to beat him at SummerSlam and beat him again at another pay-per-view. And that'll be it.
Well, we will get SummerSlam predictions going in just a little while. Before we do that, let's get another topic going. Captain of the Blue Team, Phoenix, you have 2, 3, or 4?
3.
3 is Tricky Sticky Nicky.
Oh, mate, I'm off. I'll see you later.
As you mentioned, how long has it been since Nicky defended the title?
Yeah, it's been over 30 days. Last I checked, it was 35 days.
And SummerSlam's coming up. Second biggest pay-per-view of the year. For the first time ever, it's 4 hours long. And just so that she can beat AJ's reign, they booked this massive tag team match and Nikki's not defending her championship.
Pretty much.
I tweeted Vince about that. He still hasn't got back to me.
I've never seen Vince reply to anyone.
No, he doesn't.
I don't think he really gets Twitter. He's just like, well, all the kids are into this cool thing. I want to get in on it.
But to be fair to Vince, this is the only time I'll stick up for Vince, is that can you imagine the tweets he gets on a daily basis? Yes. So I don't blame him for not responding, because this IWC is so sour.
He's probably got all his notifications turned off, and the only time he uses Twitter is to send out a tweet.
Yep. Or block someone.
Yeah, I went onto his page to see if he blocked me, but it came up with the last thing. I think his latest one was him tweeting about John Cena's 500th Make-A-Wish.
Mm. Now, can I just stop you there? John Cena isn't the only guy doing this.
Thank you.
You know, credit where credit's due, that 500 is a lot. But what about all the other wrestlers? They all do it.
Didn't Brock Lesnar doing during the week?
Exactly, Brock Lesnar did
exactly, we didn't hear about it.
No one said a word.
Lesnar done one, Orton's done a couple, Bray's, I know Bray's done at least one.
Reigns, I think Reigns has done something. You know, it's just, you know, get off the Cena Kool-Aid for a minute, will you? Please. Yeah.
And, you know, no disrespect to him or anything, but whoever was in John Cena's position, they'd do exactly the same thing.
No.
I don't know.
I don't have an opinion on this.
Like, fair play, but stop riding.
I do have an opinion on that.
It's good what he's doing, you know, plug it, but plug everyone else as well.
Exactly. Just make it a company-wide thing. Say John Cena, Dean Ambrose, Randy Orton, Bray Wyatt, and Brock Lesnar have all done Make a Wish things this week, and it would be like, okay, cool. At least they're making it obvious that the whole roster's doing it instead of just one guy doing them on his phone.
And this isn't me.
There's might been a couple as well. I'm not sure which ones, but I'm sure they've done a couple.
This isn't me being a CM Punk mark or anything, but obviously on his podcast with Colt Cabana, he said he did it just as many as John Cena did in 2012. If he did, why didn't we hear about any of them?
Because he's not the poster boy.
Exactly.
That's why. It's so confusing. People still say WWE want publicity. They shouldn't need it at this point.
No.
Well, Vince is a billionaire again now, isn't he?
Yes, he's a billionaire this week. He's now a billionaire again.
Thanks to his family. So, Vince, stay in this position where you don't do much and don't fucking touch anything else. Don't touch anything else, Vince.
Vince can do the financials.
You're a billionaire again. Congratulations. Don't touch your own dick. Don't do it.
It's like the George Lucas thing with Star Wars, wasn't it? Don't touch it. Version? Just leave it alone. You're ruining it.
Which version?
Spoiler.
Episode 1-3. Just no.
I'm going to put Hayden Christian in Return of the Jedi. Like, fucking why?
I'm a Trekkie, so all of this is just fucking a Frenchman in Germany to me. Nope. You're
reported.
What was the other major change you did was put the younger Emperor in The Empire Strikes Back instead of the... Didn't he do a chimpanzee with yellow eyes or something? They did a woman with chimpanzee eyes.
Watched for so long.
Something like that. Anyway.
You want about Jar Jar Binks?
No. There was a hologram of the Emperor in The Empire Strikes Back, and George Lucas went back and changed it to a younger version of the Emperor instead of an actress who was doing it.
The fuck?
Just give Lucas and Vince colouring books and let people actually know what they're doing and take on.
That'd be quite funny to see, actually. Vince McMahon and George Lucas in the same room.
Oh, we're trying to colour within the lines. That'd be amazing to watch.
I'm going to go back and change this. Well, I'm going to put a post-it note over this.
Listening to TLC.
Okay, so we have two topics left, and it's down to Evan Money McCabe to pick the last one before we get one left, obviously. So, 2 or 4?
I hope people at home got my Deadpool reference. 4.
4 is King PJ.
Oh.
Referring to last week's episode of Impact, where PJ Black won the TNA King of the Mountain Championship.
I'm going to be honest with you. This surprised me. This really surprised me, because the way that story was told, I thought that Robbie E was going to get a push. Possibly Chris Masters or... whatever he wants to call himself now.
Is he half or something?
I didn't do that much, Chris Masters, in the match. Certainly not enough to keep my limited attention span going.
Well, if I hadn't read any spoilers, I would have leaned towards Bobby Roode.
Well, I managed to avoid the spoilers. And I was looking, I was thinking Eric Young, to be honest.
Yeah, well, Eric Young stole it on a house show, didn't he?
Yeah, I was a bit confused about that. I thought he had the belt, but no. I'm not going to get into it. But yeah, PJ Black stole the whole damn show. He was brilliant in it.
And fucking hell, that Shooting Star Press he did at the end. Fuck me.
That was a 450.
450, yes, not Shooting Star Press. I'm getting confused with high flying moves. Jesus.
Gee, I was surprised. I showed my allegiance for GFW during that show. I was expecting so much heat, but actually not everyone was quite cool with it.
Yeah,
I was actually really surprised.
To me, it wasn't an invasion. It was more like ROH do with New Japan. It was just like a partnership show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But who knows? Maybe it'll get a bit more heated as it goes on.
I think as the weeks go on, it's going to get more and more intense.
Because obviously Bully Ray's still on the shelf.
Yep.
All right, so final topic this week is, if I can find him, Cena returns. Sorry. But yeah.
Why is that news?
Basically, so we can talk about the contract signing. But Cena's sort of through it. Go on.
He mentioned about his merchandise and all that. He did that months ago. The 15 on the back.
Yeah. You released that right before you may win your 16th title. What the fuck?
Future sale coming up on WWEshop.com. Just be like a fire sale.
To be fair, he throws a new one out every fucking week anyway. But yeah, the promo, he threw a fucking curveball at me because he came out in his old, you know, robotic, shouty Cena. And then he turned into a pretty good promo. Like, you bastard. I was slagging you off a minute ago, now I've got to praise you.
I don't care what anyone says. I'm a Cena mark now. Oh, don't get me wrong. I'm going to boom him out the building. I'm going to boom him out the building tomorrow. But it's kind of like, John Cena was the crack cocaine of professional wrestling, in the sense of that if you get into him too much, then you side with him, you like him. And I mean, there's been a couple of times where us as marks and smarks and fucking r/ square circle have just ripped him to shreds, and he's taken that and he's done his own thing with it. So he's gained my respect. So I actually can't. I was just thinking about this in the shower after sticking a bottle of wine up my ass. I was actually.
You've been hanging out with Sonny way too much.
I do. It's apologies, yes, because I'm into kink as well. So, yeah, I'm probably going to get spanked later. But I was thinking, wouldn't it be great if John Cena wins tomorrow and Sheamus cashes in the Money in the Bank contract? So you
I hate
this...
Sheamus as well, though.
You know,
well,
that's you guys the thing
about so Sheamus. Negative. Then you've got Sheamus 16 champ. You've got Cena's 16 championship reign, and then he's going to be one of the go-to for 17 to try and beat Ric Flair's record, or Ric Flair's record according to WWE.
It won't
be. According to WWE.
Michael's trying to break through with something. What are you trying to say, mate?
I was going to say the Sheamus thing. He's a Money in the Bank winner, and he tried to cash it in on Seth Rollins, obviously Orton, or killed him. Mm. It makes me think he can't cash it in anytime he wants because it's WWE making him. Wait, basically, they'll make the decision when he cashes it in, you think about it, because that's what, I mean, Money in the Bank, anytime, anywhere, whenever you want, but they're stopping Sheamus cashing it in, and they're going to decide when he cashes it in, not when he wants to. I mean, that's why I think in Money in the Bank lately,
it's basically just a kayfabe contract, isn't it?
Yeah. At first, when they first started, I thought it's like, going for it or not, they could do it anytime, but since this stopped Sheamus, I wish they'd cash it in, but obviously Randy Orton or KO'd him, stopped him, and made me think, well, WWE is making a decision for him to do it and not him himself.
It would be quite funny if he turned up to Raw, just walked up to Vince and went, I'm fucking cashing this in tonight, alright?
Yeah.
Alright.
I mean, as good as the chemistry is between Orton and Sheamus, I, for one, would like to see Sheamus just fight someone else and have Orton fight someone, go back to another old feud, say like someone who needs a good feud, some like Bad News Barrett or King Barrett now. I don't know, maybe Neville. It's just the Irish in me coming out. What with Orton? You'd have to turn Orton heel there, wouldn't you?
You could put Neville with Orton maybe, or Sheamus, someone. Barrett's dead in the water anyway, so no one's going to care what he does.
This is my point, though. In order to get Barrett back into a situation of strength. He needs a good feud.
He does, but you got to go back to the bad news gimmick. This King thing shouldn't have even begun.
It is pointless.
Have you seen Barrett's new t-shirt?
No! Was it the red one, King of Bad News, wasn't it?
Yeah, so what fucking gimmick is he using now?
I don't know. It's like a mix between the two, so... I don't know. I feel sorry for the guy. I feel sorry for him.
It's something to do with Stardust or something, isn't it, now at the moment?
Galactica Stars or some shit like that, sort of SmackDown.
Yeah.
Fucking... Alright, so...
Please don't be a tag team. Do not be a tag team. That is an over-fucking-crowded part of the WWE right now. Offload it. Maybe do that
Stardust
and then...
Thingy tag team just will not work.
The thing is, it's overcrowded, but how many tag teams are actually good? I count two. That I actually watch.
Jurassic pause from all of us, because we're all thinking then.
Exactly,
you're right.
It's either silence. There's like two. There's two tag teams on board. Prime Time Players and the New Day. I don't really care about the other tag teams.
I concur. Completely concur.
All right, well, let's get the predictions going for SummerSlam. I don't think they've announced any matches for the pre-show. It seems like they're all on the pay-per-view itself.
It'd be some garbage R-Truth match.
First one to walk through a door, you're facing R-Truth.
Here's the punchline. What if the opening match is that fucking that tag match with Barrett and Stardust and Arrow and, well, let's call them the Arrows because that's cool.
I hope it's first match. I hope it is.
All right, well, let's predict that one first then.
Yeah.
So we've got Stephen Amell, Arrow, and Neville versus Stardust and King Barrett.
Stardust gets the pinfall.
Ooh.
Over Amell.
Over... now serving Neville.
Wow. I actually would go for the reverse. Sorry, dude. Go.
I'd just like to see what's his name? What's the actor's name?
Stephen Amell.
That's it.
Stephen Amell. Let's just call him Arrow.
Yeah. To him to pin Stardust and just make it, like, you know, and then Stardust complain next time more. But he got pinned by an actor and all that, so.
Yeah.
Well, I hope Neville.
So did John Cena at WrestleMania 27, though. And WrestleMania 28. And, well, yeah, nearly WrestleMania 29.
Good morning.
I'm probably going to go with Neville to get
a Cena lost to Kevin Federline as well.
Oh, K-Fed, Jesus Christ. Yeah, but he's not an actor. He's not even a friggin' rapper.
Right up his roots of writing, right there. Twice as well on a fucking Raw and a pay-per-view. Who booked that shit then?
I will admit, though, that was a pretty good rap.
My dirty hand. I would.
That was a pretty good rap, though, that Cena done to this K-Fed. I'll be spearing Brittany.
Nice.
That's the only line I remember. All right. So, next match. Primetime Players defending the championships, tag team championships, against Lucha Dragons, Los Matadors, and New Day.
Oh, it's a four-way.
Yeah, I'm just going to say New Day regain. Because they haven't done anything with Primetime Players since they've won the titles.
And everything is
I was going to say Lucha Dragons, but they haven't done anything with them since they debuted on there, so...
Well, they're from NXT, that's what they do.
I hope that Paul gets the win.
I'm going to go with PTP, I don't know why.
Okay.
I'm going to go PTP as well, because they haven't hit their stride yet. It hasn't felt like a good run. They haven't really had that moment yet to validate them, so hopefully this is it.
Alright.
Yeah, PTP, I think.
Next match, which I couldn't give a flying fuck about, is the triple threat match for the Intercontinental Championship. Ryback versus Big Slow versus The Miz.
I'm going to sleep on that ton.
Yeah, I think that might be my head break.
That'll be my piss break.
I want The Miz to win.
Yeah, me too.
Well, this is how bad the situation is.
Whoever wins, I lose.
That was me every Divas match. Until now.
Even though it pains me, I'll go with the Miz as well, though.
Well, he's one of the best heels in the company, so why not?
I wouldn't be surprised, actually, if they kept it on Ryback, because they seem intent on running with him now.
I hope they're running out another
the ploy to try and get him over again, isn't it?
Yeah. How many attempts have you tried to get him over?
This will be the fourth time.
Jeez.
I've got to it with us, count.
Oh, man. All right. What's that? Three matches? Four matches? Up next, how about Kevin Owens and Cesaro?
Now
there's a tough one.
I do have an opinion on this. I did actually have a thing about the triple threat, but I half don't care, and I'm half recovering from corpsing. But I think whoever wins this one will be pushed into a position where they go against the winner of Rollins and Cena, provided that Sheamus does not cash in his money in the bank. So, I'm going to go with Owens. Like Owens to win it. No, and then it means there's a possibility of Cena and fucking Owens again. Oh, I don't know.
Well, I'm going with Kevin Owens.
Yeah, coming.
I'm torn on this because you need something big for Owens, but Cesaro's in the middle of a push, so.
Well, this is where they've cornered both of them.
In a sense, I don't mind this because something's got to give.
Yeah.
To me, this is like a. This is up there in terms of main event kind of fights. I think this is like the. This is the IWC's main event. Fucking former Ring of Honor guys. So, for me, it's one of those ones where everybody fucking wins. But the minus of that is whoever loses maybe is in a dangerous place of being placed into limbo.
Yeah.
And that's my only concern about the loser. I'm sure it's going to be a fucking magnificent match, but I'm worried about who loses this.
Ever so slightly towards Cesaro. I don't know why, though.
Right. Any more predictions?
I'm sitting here thinking it's going to be a DQ or a double count out to protect them. Because I can't see either one gaining or losing anything from this.
But that means the rematch will be after the second biggest pay-per-view of the year.
Well, that's why I'm hoping a title kind of gets slid into the rivalry to spice it up a bit. But I think it's going to be a DQ or double count out or something. I can't see either one winning, to be honest.
Which is exactly why Kevin Owens should have won the US title.
Should have, but WWE logic, you know.
Yep. Fuck fans. All right.
Kevin Owens versus Seth Rollins, nice.
Yeah.
So John Cena.
Has that happened
yet?
Not that I know of.
No. It hasn't.
Tag together.
Oh.
Oh yeah, well they've both been heels, haven't they?
Ring of Honor last year.
I want to see Owens versus Brock down the line. That's
probably
what
happened in ROH, but I don't think it's happened on the main roster on Raw or anything. Alright. Next match, Dolph Ziggler versus Rusev.
Who cares? Who really cares?
You know what, actually, I want Rusev to destroy Ziggler. Because that's what happens when you fuck my bitches. I get cross.
I'm sure Mike agrees with you.
After that promo last time. To be honest, I could have been more nicer, but it's Ziggler. I don't know. I can't say nothing about him. That's much hate him. I just don't know.
We're about to call the police after your promo last week.
Just give Ziggler the win. Let him super kick Rusev and get the three and then do something with him, for God's sake.
I've got to ask, why do you hate Ziggler so much?
The mixed match.
Why don't I hate... I don't know. He's too cocky. I think he's too cocky, and I think I don't know. I just hate him. He's just one of those wrestlers I just can't stand, really. Right? To me, in the Spirit Squad, I hated him. He came to Dolph Ziggler. I hate him ever since, he's become a single, wrestler as Dolph Ziggler. As soon as I watched his first match as Dolph Ziggler, I just never liked him. I don't know why. It's just, I think he's, to me, he's too cocky and he's too bloody boring for my liking. Really.
Is the IWC's okay. New ravishing Rick Rude? And let's just leave that there, because I, as good as he is, you have people asking and pushing for Rick Rude to be in the Hall of Fame. But if you're honest with yourselves, and I know there's a lot of ICW members that won't be, what's Rick Rude done?
He was the original Val Venus.
Okay. Yeah. The original Val Venus. Let me just stop you there. The original Val Venus. Are we really giving a gimmick of a porn star, which, you know, because WWE PG now is. In fact, there's going to be a time where they'll be pushing for porn stars to go in the Hall of Fame. Chinese already in there. So why not fucking China? Why not fucking ravishing Big Room?
Hang on,
right
wait, whoa.
John Cena can induct Kendra Likes.
Good. Well, yes, you could. Rick Rude was a great performer. He was a great heel when he won the IC title when it meant something.
And he was in DX. Yeah.
And he was in DX and probably NWO, because let's face it, everyone WCW was at one stage. But yes, he should be. He should be.
Yeah, no.
But as far as China goes, I can't see it happening. They won't even return her phone calls. What chance does she have of getting in the Hall of Fame? Let's be serious about this.
If she does that Sean moment again.
Yeah, I mean, what the hell was that at Roddy's funeral? How sick in the head must you be?
This is the semen. Of all else, they blame semen.
Seriously, it's just, it's sick in the head to do that. Of all times and places to try and suck up to Triple H for making all these rumours up and chucking mud at that company for years and then just do it at Roddy Piper's funeral. No, just no. Fuck off.
All right, we'll move on plastic to the next.
Plastic melting in your face, you fucking... Just move on. I'm sick. Okay. I'm done with it. Just, yeah, forget all right. it.
All right, let's move on to... Randy Orton versus Sheamus, part 37,322.
Fucking pointless. What is the point?
The point is, creative have nothing for you.
I don't know. I said, then let me go, but you know.
Each other more times and Big Show turned heel.
Yeah. Should we just predict this one quickly then?
Yeah.
Orton,
then Sheamus cashes in at the end of the night, becomes champion. Bang.
Oh, please fucking don't.
I think if Sheamus wins, then he won't cash in.
Agreed.
If John Cena wins, I hope Sheamus does cash in. So.
You would think all the stars would align for that.
Mm. Alright, so we also have a tag team match. Two-thirds of the Wyatt family versus two-thirds of the Shield.
Oh, I forgot about this one. I don't care.
Teddy Long is doing such a big dance right now. I forgot this thing is so tag heavy. Yeah.
You know, the worst thing about it is it's so regular heavy as well. There's no special stipulations for any of the matches.
No, it's just straight up matches. Surprising. Yeah.
Which is good if you like, you know, straightforward wrestling.
For
but...
this match, I'm praying I'm on my goddamn knees. Let Ambrose turn heel, please.
Well, that is the rumor.
Yes.
I thought it would turn. They'd have Reigns turns heel, but I can imagine someone in the Shield turning on the other one.
Yeah.
History repeating.
So I think we're predicting a no contest, or.
I
suppose it couldn't be a no contest because you can't get DQ'd for attacking your own partner.
Or
I think it'll be a. The Wyatt victory, but it'll be one like Roman Reigns turning on Ambrose or Ambrose turning on Reigns.
No, I reckon what's going to happen late on in the match, Ambrose is going to hit Reigns with dirty deeds and give the Wyatts the win, then possibly join or just walk off, one of the two.
I was just about to say that Dean Ambrose turning on Reigns and then joining the Wyatt family. That I'd like to see.
Yeah.
I don't see Wyatt, Ambrose fitting in with the Wyatts. So.
Yeah, Roman's already got the beard.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so Wyatt family on that one, which leads us to the two main events. We'll get the title one out of the way first, because meh. So, John Cena, US champion versus Seth Rollins, world heavyweight champion, title for title.
Seth Rollins. Just give it to Seth Rollins.
No, I'm going to say, John Cena, I'm sick of Rollins' title run. It's been so badly booked and it's made me not care. So give it back to Cena so I actually care about the title again.
And you can cuss him a lot.
Oh, I'll be fucking cussing him a lot.
How many hashtag cancelled WWE Network tweets are we going to see if Cena wins?
You're going to subscribers.
I'll be hashtagging cancel the world.
I'll be just hashtagging Cena wins, lol.
I'll be hashtagging cancel the IWC or square circle loses, lol.
Well, my head, my heart says Seth Rollins, my head says John Cena.
But why? What's Rollins going to do if he beats Cena? Where'd you go?
Where's Cena going to go?
Yes, the thing is that I can see multiple angles that Cena can do, but with Rollins, not so much.
They'll give Cena another up-and-coming star if he loses on at SummerSlam. They'll give him another up-and-coming star for to bury.
Well, yes. is it? No, wait, hang on. The open challenges with the US title, he's brought in young talent and made them look phenomenal. Yes, they've lost, but they've looked like $1 million while doing it. It's not burying. So if he did the open challenge with the world title, you can imagine how good these people are going to look.
Agreed.
But what happened to Bray Wyatt and Kevin Owens? Point.
Now, okay, right, the Bray Wyatt thing.
You've got a point.
That was, right, the story for that was wrong. The match itself wasn't very good because it was all about Cena turning bad, basically, wasn't it? And he wouldn't. And it's just
I like that one at WrestleMania.
Bullshit. Wrong decision. Yeah, fair enough. Kevin Owens, same thing. They should have given the US title. It was primed and ready. The time was right. And for some reason, they said no. I don't know why, but the two out of three matches were phenomenal.
I know why.
You know,
since Kevin next fucking team. Dunn.
Kevin Dunn could be.
Nicely done. No pun. No, actually, the thing is, because he was in NXT and he was booked as, you know, this coming from inverted brackets, the developmental organization, then there would be this thing about Owens having the NXT title and the US title and being OP. But that brings me back to my Brock Lesnar point. I feel that if someone is as strong as they appear to be, let them run with it, period of time. And then, like, then when he gets too big, then we'll deal with that problem. But the thing is to push your talent instead of just pushing one guy. And that's what they've been doing with Cena, and that's what they've been doing with Lesnar. But with Lesnar, we're beginning to see the nerfing of him, if you will. So, for me, I would have been... I still don't know. Maybe he could have had the US and the NXT title.
So we seem pretty split on this decision then, with Cena and Rollins. Yeah. Right, well, we also forgot about the three Team Divas match, which I'm too pissed off to care about, because Sticky Nikki should
that's
be defending a title.
They've messed it up already with this. They should have done a separate Divas title match, and then if they still wanted to do a tag, do a three-way normal tag match instead of this faction stuff.
Four-hour pay-per-view, and they've only got time for one Divas match, and they fill the gap with Orton and Sheamus for the umpteenth fucking time.
Yeah, and watch Bella get the pinfall.
Oh yeah, of course. They'll pin fucking Sasha or Charlotte.
No, because
Sticky Nikki as well.
Oh yeah.
It'll be Sticky Nicky pinning Sasha Banks or Charlotte.
You see, now that I'm salty about, they had this big hoo-ha and the hashtags and the huge pops and Charlotte and the boss pinning and winning, and then they do this shit. It's like, hey, do you want to come in for a blowjob? Sure, have a blowjob. And then you take your trousers down and the bitch tickles your bollocks and pushes you out the door. That's what it feels like. Feels like it's just been false advertising from the get-go, and it's made me so fucking angry and disappointed that someone in the WWE has it for Divas, and they can and someone still believes that Divas cannot main event a pay-per-view, and it's bullshit.
Well, To expand on that point, is this really a revolution, or is this just patching up the massive holes they've left this Divas ship in?
This is hiding exactly what I just said. Pushing someone that we don't. Well, you can take it or leave it. Like I said on my show, it's women. It's professional women wrestling against sport fitness models turned wrestling divas.
It's shown at every match. They've looked so inferior every time they've been in the ring with Charlotte or Becky or Sasha. They've looked so inferior. It's not even funny.
But the punchline is now is that we have these reality shows, and from those reality shows, we have a following that support these sport fitness things. So now you've got the IWC, you've got the fucking Square Circle, you have us, Smarks and Marks, and now this new generation of wrestling fans who have come from these reality TV shows, and they don't have a fucking clue what they're talking about.
They don't know. They wouldn't know the difference between a wristwatch and a wristlock.
Agreed. Armbar. You need to get Chris Jericho on the fucking blower, nigger.
Basically, it's not a revolution. It's a distraction.
Oh, I'm so worked about. I'm actually shaking. I'm that angry about it.
It's a distraction.
That's what I love about bitches is because it's a hide up. That's what it is.
All it is distracting you from the fact that Nikki Bella is about to become the longest reigning Divas champion, which is fucking bullshit.
And not because of
AJ Lee, because of who she is.
Because of who she's banging and because AJ Lee had the record before. That's all that is.
She's done nothing to deserve it either.
No. That blow, John.
Exactly.
All right, so
Natalia, I will say it, I'm blue in the face. Natalia should have had the run. She should be the one to break the record, not some fucking surgery enhanced bitch who slipped her way up the chain.
I feel this all started way back when Beth Phoenix was days away from breaking the belt, and fucking, I don't even know if it was Nikki Bella, I don't care, but one of the Bellas pinned her, and she wasn't meant to drop the title, but because she was injured, one of the Bellas took that opportunity, and oh, it just makes me so angry.
That was Nikki as well, wasn't it?
Got me worked up now as well. Oh, Jesus.
Fucking hell.
I'm sorry, right, I just love the pussy so much, it makes me drunk.
All right, so final match, Brock Lesnar, Undertaker.
Don't care. Sting comes in, drops Undertaker like a bad habit, cut to black.
Ooh.
Mic drop.
Just mic drop, I'm done. Fuck SummerSlam.
That was one of the predictions. I was going to go with either Taker gets the victory, then Sting comes out, or Taker's about to get the victory, and Sting, the lights go out, and Sting comes in the ring. It sets up their match for WrestleMania.
I'm just going to go simple, Undertaker wins. That's it. Because I'm not believing all these fucking Sting rumors anymore.
I don't care for the Sting rumors.
If that's the case, what if obviously Taker beats Brock? What's next for Brock? You know, this is
exactly what I was going to say. Well played, man. Well played.
He goes home.
He goes home, gets a few more acres for his farm, and waits for the phone call to be called back to Raw.
Yeah, I feel that we forget that Lesnar has this image of being a merc for hire, so maybe he will fuck off back to his farm for a bit until the WWE says he's got too much popularity, break him, and that's it.
All right, so
maybe WWE could go down the road of I'm just saying it, you know, maybe like kill it, but they, for Brock, it could make it Sting versus Taker at WrestleMania, and maybe put Brock in it and make a triple threat match.
That match would not be very good. That match would not be good. Sting can hold his own. Undertaker's fallen apart. Brock Lesnar would have to do so much work to carry that. Sting and Taker.
If what you guys say about Taker happens, wouldn't that be a good opportunity to put Owens with Lesnar?
Please.
Well, do you know what? If they're going to bring Taker back and turn him kind of heel, but not, just do it out of nowhere. Just put Owens with Lesnar. I'll be happy. I don't even care. There's no continuity anyway.
I was thinking either Owens or Orton. Lesnar.
I think Taker should have kicking niggers in the nuts as he's finishing out. Never mind that tombstone bollocks, nigger. You can't even fucking lift no more. Kick him in the nuts.
All right, so that's the SummerSlam predictions down. Don't forget it tonight, 1 a.m. Only on the WWE Network.
$9.99.
Oh yeah, thanks. I forgot how much it is.
Hang on, it's been 4 hours.
It's yep. What?
Yeah, 4 hours.
4 hours.
It'll be 12, wouldn't it? 12.
I don't know. They used to push WrestleMania back an hour when it was on for 4 hours, but.
Can I mention one last thing before we move? Why is John Stewart hosting this?
It's happy with my mind. It's like, why they've got Demi Lovato doing this theme tune.
Oh, dude, don't. Fucking hell, don't.
talk about driving the point home.
It makes no sense.
It doesn't.
It makes no sense.
John Stewart to a point.
Fucking.
Have him do a something with Seth Rollins and then just completely ignore him for the whole match. Sorry, the whole pay-per-view. But this demigod, whatever the fuck her name is, what? Why?
Demi Lovato. Fucking cutting decision.
Book Lamb of God to do it, motherfuckers. Get some meat on you.
All right, now let's go to in the hot seat round one, which means we're going to temporarily lose the blue team.
Okay. Aww.
We'll see you in part two.
Shut out, you dickheads.
No hacking.
I don't know how.
You don't hack, you Google.
All right, so here we go.
It's a Mountain Dew.
All right,
this team is so full of piss and vinegar, it's not even funny. Such a salty team today.
Salty.
This podcast is full of salt and vinegar. All right, question.
IWC members saying, yes, my children, come over to the dark side.
Right. Let the hate flow through you.
Okay, question one. How long did Justin Gabriel hold the FCW Championship for in 2009? 100 days, 150, or 175? I'll give you options.
Oh, good.
100.
Oh, yeah, because that's going to make it so much easier.
Well, you got a 1-2 chance of getting it right.
Oh, I forgot. Well, sorry, go on. What was it, 100 days?
100 days, 150, or 175?
Sorry, what's his title?
FCW World Championship.
What the fuck?
It's before NXT, Florida Championship Wrestling. Yeah.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Wow.
I'll be surprised at who would actually get this.
You've actually caught me with my pants down because I've said previously on the show I used to watch FCW, but I don't remember Justin Gabriel in that at all, so I must have just missed that.
Can you imagine if I gave you no options for this?
Yeah, he did.
If you thought we were salty before, Evan, I'm going to let you say, I'm kind of leaning towards the 100 days. I don't know why, but it's up to you.
And the punchline with this is that NXT does not doesn't acknowledge the FCW, so it's not like it's not going to come up anytime soon. What are the options again?
100 days, 150 days, or 175 days.
I'm going to go with 175. I can imagine him being the type of person that they wanted to push. Oh, no, I'm sorry, I forgot. Vince hates bigger guys.
hates small guys, yeah.
Yeah. Let's say 100 days then.
Okay, you going with 100 days?
James?
You're the captain. I was leaning towards
100 days. Yeah, I'm asking if you agree with this.
I'm kind of with you on that, yeah. I'm leaning towards 100 days too.
Yeah, so we're going to say 100 days.
It actually was 175 days.
Oh man.
Ah, so...
That's the CM Punk thing.
To be honest, I don't think many people would have got that anyway, but
Question two. Who did The Undertaker legitimately knock out at SummerSlam 1998?
Stone
Cold, wasn't it? Was it Stone Cold at 98? I'm trying to think. 98. What happened 98? I'm going to say Stone Cold because I can't really think of anyone else he would have faced.
Was Bret Hart still in the company in 98?
No. He did 97. Bret screwed Bret, remember?
Are you going with Stone Cold?
Yeah, let's go with Stone Cold.
Let's go with Stone Cold.
YOLO.
Well, yes! Wrong button there. Yes, it was right. Stone Cold.
Played.
It was, you know, back in the day when he used to do the whip into the ropes and then bend down for a backdrop.
Yep.
And Stone Cold kicked him so hard his head just whacked Austin in the chin and knocked him out.
Shit.
Yeah, it was only for a couple. It was only for a minute or so.
It's pretty intense back then.
Yeah. All right, that's 1 point on the score sheet. Question three. Sweet. During the 2005 Summer of Punk in ROH, who defeated CM Punk in a 2 out of 3 falls match in his final ROH match?
Final ROH match? Who's the final match against?
What? I have two names.
I thought his final ROH match was against Colt Cabana. Was that 2 out of 3? Shit.
I don't know that much about that Ring of Honor, but I'm basically throwing out the names that would have made sense to me then. And the only names I can think of are Nigel McGuinness, Samoa Joe, or what you said, James, Colt Cabana.
Colt Cabana. I'm sure that was his last match against Colt Cabana.
All right, then I'll trust you with that. We'll go Colt Cabana.
All right.
Nice.
2 points. It was Colt Cabana. August 15th, 2005.
These were hard this time. These are questions from really hard.
You got on pretty quickly, though.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to go to a break and play the mystery pay-per-view theme. It is also worth a point, but see if you can guess what it is as well. And we'll see you in part two.
Everybody, this is Johnny Ferrari in Las Vegas, and you're listening to the Swerve Talk Network featuring Max Wrestling, Sunday Stag, Offshoot Radio, and more. Coming soon at the Swerve Talk Network on Twitter for more information.
And we're back. If you guess what pay-per-view that song was from, good for you. Guys, you know the rules. Shout it out as soon as you know it. Did anyone here get it?
Bad Blood 2004.
Belmont was there first. It was. Yes! Bad Blood 2004. Fuck. That makes it 3 points to the red team. So, blue team, you need to get all these questions right to even the score.
Okay,
question one. And you have got options for this because it's quite difficult. How long did Justin Gabriel hold the FCW World Championship for in 2009? 100 days, 150 days, or 175 days?
Damn you.
We need... what are the options?
100, 150, or 175 days.
I'm going to guess, I don't know, maybe 150, maybe? I don't know.
Yeah, your guess would be as good as mine, because I honestly don't know.
Alright, Phoenix, you're the captain.
Yeah, well, go with Mike's answer.
150.
I don't.
Yeah.
It was 175 days. And this isn't worth a point, but he actually beat the person that he also held the WWE Tag Team Championships with, which was...
Heath Slater, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, Heath Slater.
All right, so still 3-0, but if it makes you feel any better, the red team didn't get that one either.
No, that was a really hard question. I didn't have a clue.
And they only went with that question because he just won a legitimate singles title, if you can call it that. Question two. Who did The Undertaker legitimately knock out at SummerSlam 1998?
Shit, how was he facing?
SummerSlam.
Yeah, SummerSlam 98. In Madison
Square
Garden. No idea. Stone Cold?
Are you going with Stone Cold Steve Austin?
Yeah, if Mike's called it.
Yes, it was Stone Cold during a WWE Championship match. An accidental headbutt to the bottom of Stone Cold's chin. Okay, final question. This will make it 3-2 if you get it right. During the 2005 Summer of Punk in ROH, who defeated CM Punk in a 2-out-of-3 falls match in his final Ring of Honor match?
Colt Cabana comes to mind. They used to have tremendous matches there, didn't they? What year was it?
2005.
Yeah, I'll go with Colt Cabana.
Yeah, go Craig.
That's all I can think of.
Okay. It was Colt Cabana, and the score is a 3-2. So, blue team, you've got a little bit of work to do if you want to avoid that podcast promo.
The suspense.
It's killing me. All right, Random Wrestling Records up next for the next point. This week, I want to know which wrestler has the most Hall of Fame entries.
What?
Wait, what?
Hang on.
Not just WWE Hall of Fame, you know, there's WCW.
Oh.
Hardcore WCW Hall of Fame, NWA.
WCW had a Hall of Fame.
Apparently.
Yeah. Well, I've already got one name that comes to mind.
Okay. Yeah, me too.
Do we both have to agree, or can we both say different ones?
Yeah, you can confirm.
How this usually works is that we say a bunch of names and you
kind of say...
And then you sort of agree on one.
I'm leaning towards Ric Flair on this one.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking.
Yeah, because you think of the horse and all that, so...
All right, Blue Team, have you got one?
I was thinking Ric Flair as well.
Oh. Yeah, me too.
You're going to have to think of someone else now.
Sting?
No, hang on, I'm not Sting. I was thinking Hulk Hogan, but I'm not too sure.
You know, I was just thinking that.
Yeah, I was thinking that. That would have been a good other answer.
I'm thinking Hulk Hogan.
Do you want to go with Hogan then?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. What's his name?
Alright, you guys are going with Hulk Hogan.
James, okay. Just quickly, what's his name? The guy who was WWF holder for like fucking 2 years or something stupid like that, until he lost it to Billy Graham.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
What's his fucking name?
Bruno something?
I think so, but I can't remember the name.
I can't remember his name.
Buddy Rogers?
Buddy Rogers? Just, no, it wasn't Buddy Rogers.
Should we just stick with Flair? Cause
yeah, fuck it.
Yeah, just stick with Flair. YOLO. All
right. I reckon Dazzy's going to say it, and I'm going to kick myself in the face. So go ahead and...
All right, so we've got Ric Flair versus Hulk Hogan.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
All right, the closest is Ric Flair. Flair is in 5 Hall of Fames. Hulk Hogan is in 3.
Wow.
You said Sting. Sting's actually only in the TNA Hall of Fame.
TNA. I was thinking you said Sting.
Yeah.
And if there's any justice in the world, it'll soon be 2, but that's a whole different subject.
At the top of the list, the only person who's in 6 Hall of Fames is Terry Funk.
Terry Funk?
Wow.
Bloody hell.
Terry Funk is in.
Shocked.
He's in the WWE Hall of Fame, obviously. The WCW Hall of Fame, Hardcore Hall of Fame, NWA Hall of Fame, and then he's in the Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame and the Wrestling Observer Hall of Fame.
Wow, jeez. Fair play to Terry Funk.
Who's in the rest of the top 3?
There was Terry Funk, the only one that's in 6, and then there's 5 people in 5 Hall of Fames, including Ric Flair. Harley Race, Gordon Solie, Antonio Inoki.
The Japanese guy. Just recently went into WWE's Hall of Fame, if I remember serving correctly.
Yes, 2010.
Oh, really?
Who was it? Was it Tanner? No. Yeah. Jesus, I forgot his name. It'll come to me. Alright, so... yeah. So the red team are in the lead still. It's now 4 points to 2. Now, there isn't a play-by-play this week. Instead, we've got a new round. Which is called Obscure Champions.
I can see where this is going. Oh, Vince Russo, you stupid bastard.
If you watch Pointless in the UK, you'll know how this works. Yeah. If you're not from the UK, basically, I ask for a question and the answer I want is the least obvious.
Oh.
So the question this week...
All right, go ahead.
The question this week is light heavyweight champions in the WWE.
Okay, all right, I've got one.
The answer I want is who's got the least reigns.
Who's got the least reigns as light heavyweight champion?
Oh, sorry, shortest time as light heavyweight champion.
Oh, shortest time. All right. I'm
immediately thinking Randy Orton.
What, light heavyweight?
Yeah, I'm thinking there was a time when he was feuding with Jamie Noble on SmackDown.
Jesus. Who you got? You got like Billy Kidman, Jamie Noble, Matt Hardy.
Yeah.
X-Pac. How long did he have it for? X-Pac had it for a bit. Was it a long reign?
I'm thinking. I tell you another name that comes to mind. Dean Malenko.
Oh, that's good. That's good. Actually, I didn't think of that.
Yeah. So I'm torn between Randy Orton and Dean Malenko.
Well, out of them two, if I had to choose, I'd say Dean Malenko.
Fuck it, let's go Dean Malenko. If you want to.
Blue team,
yeah,
you got anybody?
Yeah, let's do it. Dean Malenko.
I've got two names in mind.
Okay.
If it's X-Pac, I'm going to drop kick myself in the face.
One is Jeff Hardy.
Mm-hmm.
And the other one was Scotty Too Hotty.
All right. Yeah. Okay, I'll do Dean Malenko first. Dean Malenko held it for 35 days.
Okay, that's relatively short considering the current landscape.
Blue team, which one are you going with? Scotty Too Hotty or Jeff Hardy?
I think Scotty had it the least, so I'm going to go with Scotty Too Hotty.
Yeah.
And you have the point. It was 8 days Scotty Too Hotty held it for.
Oh, wow. I didn't even know Scotty Too Hotty actually had the light heavyweight title.
Yeah, he won it from... Yeah, it was back in 2000. He won it from Dean Malenko on an episode of SmackDown. Then he lost it the Backlash to Dean Malenko.
Wow.
All right, so 4-3.
Nice.
Nice new little round for you. I think Phoenix enjoyed that better than play-by-play.
Yeah.
All right, Name That Card is up next.
Oh, I hate these. I really hate these.
You usually get these pretty quick, though.
I know, but still. Okay, go ahead.
All right, you should know how this works by now. I'll go through the list of matches at a certain pay-per-view. First one to guess which pay-per-view I'm talking about, guess the point. Okay. First match. The Headbangers versus Goldust and Mark Merrill.
Oh, fucking hell.
In Your House 1993?
Nope.
In Your House 96, probably. That's around the time.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, it's been 96, 97.
I had the Headbangers confused.
Which ones?
Huh? Oh, no, I was just saying, I get the Head Shrinkers and the Headbangers confused.
Oh, yeah, Headbangers with the Unks, Martian Thrasher.
The Head Shrinkers were the Samoans.
They're the Samoans beasts, yeah.
All right, match two. Taka Michinoku defending the Light Heavyweight Championship against Pantera, not the band.
Cowboys from Hell Rift to kick in. Oh, no, it wasn't Unforgiven.
Don't know who these fucking wrestlers are. Except for Headbang.
It's Attitude Era days.
Yeah.
To go back to it.
Do you want another match?
Yeah, have another one.
The Godwins versus the Quebecers.
Who the fuck?
I'm sure I've seen this recently. I'll be kicking myself by the end of this.
In my mind, I think it's 93, and then I hear something like that, and then I think it's 95, and then I hear something like that, and I think it's 2001. So, unless I hear a match.
What used to be the pay per view after WrestleMania was Unforgiven?
I think it was Backlash.
What, 96, 97?
I think Unforgiven was like the interesting kind of thing.
Alright, match four was Justin Bradshaw versus Jeff Jarrett for the NWA North American Heavyweight Championship.
I probably have seen this recently, I can't fucking think.
Justin Bradshaw.
Oh, so annoying.
Next three matches may be your biggest
clue. Was it No Way Out, 96?
No.
No Way Out, 1997?
Nope.
Any idea?
Oh my god, alright, next.
Yeah, the blue team's being quite quiet.
Yeah, Craig's quietly hacking. Typing in these fucking matches, as I'm saying, probably.
Alright, next match was Ken Shamrock, Ahmed Johnson, and the Disciples of Apocalypse versus the Nation of Domination.
Okay, now I'm completely lost. Armour Johnson barely ever wrestled. He was on the physio table 90% of his career, so I can't.
Disciples of the Apocalypse were Chains, Skull, and 8-Ball.
8-Ball, DOA. I don't know.
Do you need another match?
We're going to need all of them, right?
Yeah, there's this match, and then there's the main event, so... Kane versus Vader.
Fucking hell, you see...
What, that's the main event?
No, the main event's next.
No Way Out 97.
Kane versus Vader.
No Way Out what?
97.
No.
98?
Oh, right.
It was
wait,
No
wait.
Way Out
1998.
Oh. 90... Point to the blue team.
Fuck. Yeah, it's really... I could not figure that one out.
I believe the scores are now even 4-4.
4-4.
I just went a year there.
So I knew it was around.
That's what we used
like,
to do on the show anyway.
I knew it was like either side of WrestleMania. I just couldn't think of the right one.
Yeah, the main event was Stone Cold, Owen Hart, Cactus Jack, and Chainsaw Charlie versus Triple H, Savio Vega, and the New Age Outlaws in a non-sanctioned.
Oh, see, if you said that, I would have got that straight away. Oh, shit.
I didn't even know this match exists.
My favourite part in that match is Billy Gunn just runs into the ring and Stone Cold throws a trash can across.
Just throws a trash can.
Slaps him in the head.
That stunner on China, though, that was pretty
good.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. Right at the end.
Yeah.
Trying to walk away. No. All right.
No. Again. Tries to flip him off. No, he gets stunned for it.
Yeah, you can trash talk him, just don't flip him off.
No. There is a limit.
All right, so that takes us to the final round, Mystery Superstar, and this is for all the marbles. So at this point, it doesn't really matter if you get it before the first three clues or not. Either way, you still win if you get it right.
And that's for a Caribbean gentleman. He's Nigerian.
We shall see. Your first clue is a former United States champion.
Chris Benoit. Oh, no, wait. No, he doesn't exist anymore.
WWE.
Not Chris Benoit, not MVP.
Stevie Richards.
No, wait.
Stevie. Nope.
Was it in WWE, not WCW or anything like that?
Yeah, I can't really answer that.
Oh, alright.
I'll tell you why after the things.
John Cena.
Nope.
Eddie Guerrero.
Nope.
Big Show.
Nope. Also a former ECW world champion.
Lashley.
Nope.
ECW champ. US champ. Wait, what the fuck?
What's Lashley?
No.
I can't think of anyone that was...
Made his WWE debut in 2001.
So he could have been a
part of your That doesn't help because of the invasion angle.
Christian?
No.
Would be Hugh Morris. He's one of the most irrelevant people ever in wrestling.
Is that humorous?
What?
Next clue. Made his ECW debut in 1998.
Raven?
No.
Mysterio?
No.
No, Sandman didn't wrestle in the WWE.
All right.
No very convincing.
Jesus Christ.
If you get it right, you win either way, but this is your last chance to get 3 points. Former NWA Heavyweight Champion.
NWA? Oh,
Ric Flair. Arch
No, Phoenix, what did you say?
I said Ric Flair, but I know it's my wife.
No.
Ric Flair in ECW.
Alright. Sam Punk?
No.
Hang on, I'm trying to think.
I'll call Holly.
No, you ready for the final two clues?
Yeah, please, just give us the final two clues.
Former member of EV 2.0.
Oh,
bust!
Tommy Dreamer.
Nope.
Bollocks.
Sabu.
Nope.
Michael Orson, something like that. Someone obscure.
Nope.
Has anyone said Mick Foley?
Nope, not Mick Foley.
No, it's not Mick Foley.
Terry Funk.
Nope. Final clue. Now wrestles in NXT.
Oh, jeez.
Rhino!
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 Belmont was there first, the red team.
Yes! Kissing!
Bullshit!
Guitar to Felix's face!
Bullshit!
Crime area slap nut!
That is the first time we've gone the distance.
Team money! Team money got it!
I didn't mean to be on shelter. That's been
reported. We'll be spending the money on Agent Patrol.
Okay, we will take a short break now while we get the podcast promo ready. And we will also be finally announcing the matches for the podcast promo championship beginning next month. So don't go anywhere.
Hi, this is Anthony.
And this is Gartee.
We are the forces of radio.
The faces for radio.
Come relax with us every Thursday. We love hosting Feces for Radio.
That's Faces for Radio.
Can you please remember to get the name of the show right?
Sorry.
We tackle sports, entertainment, and have a kick-ass soundboard. Erasers for Radio has it all.
Faces for Radio. Find us on the VOCNation.com, listen to us live, or download it later. Follow us on Twitter at Faces for Radio 1. That's Faces for Radio. Funky for Radio. Shut up.
And we're back. So it's time to get the podcast promo options, and then we will decide the matches for the podcast promo championship. So, blue team, who wants to get their options first?
I'll get mine first.
Okay, well, you're volunteering to go first this week.
Yeah, it doesn't mean I'm getting a promo first, though.
Well, it kind of does.
No, it doesn't.
Okay. All right, pick a current pay-per-view, a number, and a colour.
Number 5.
Yep.
Night of Champions, and yep. Black.
Okay. Your opponent is Roman Reigns. Your match is an Iron Man match. And he spilt paint thinner over your car.
Oh, man, see, I could have made
some. Okay, Mike.
15. Extreme Rules.
Yep.
And Red.
Red. Alright, your opponent is Daniel Bryan. The match is Hell in a Cell. And D-Bry doesn't respect you.
Alright.
And D-Bry doesn't get medically cleared either.
He won't be after Hell in a Cell, Christ. Okay, while you get those promos ready, I'll announce the matches for the Podcast Promo Championship beginning next month. So, first match is... Mike Chadwick. Versus... Evan Money Makeba.
You're gonna die, bitch!
I know.
Match 2.
The first step is admittance.
Match
the first
two.
Step's a bit of defeat.
The death.
Match 2 is James Belmont.
Against
the Phoenix.
Oh, I'm going to tear you up something serious, chronic, I don't know.
Fucking hell. Now, that is a coincidence, because I pulled out the 4 people that are on today's show.
Is that as coincidental as these WWE polls?
Seriously.
Options of the same kind of match.
Seriously, a coincidence. I wasn't looking.
Oh, fair enough.
Alright. Oh, fucking hell, I've lost him now. Match 3. The Butcher. Versus Brad LaFrat.
Ooh, that's an interesting pairing, actually.
Which leaves Kenny Killer versus Johnny Ferrari.
No, that's actually one of the more, I'm looking forward to that one. That one should be even.
Yeah. All right, that gets started next month. Now, Phoenix, Mike, do you need more time for your promos?
Yes.
Okay, we will take another short break. And here's a quick word from our sponsors at VOC Nation.
Entertainment with an attitude.
Fear is just one enemy.
This is the VOC Nation Radio Network.
All right, there we go. Now it's time for the final segment of the show, the podcast promos. And I believe Phoenix is still putting the finishing touches on his, but Mike Chadwick's all ready to go.
Uh-huh.
All right. You're up first. Pick up the mic.
Daniel Bryan. I used to respect you a lot, and you don't respect me, and for some fucking reason, he's too busy fucking Brie Bella to respect anyone, including me. So, inside Hell in a Cell, I'm going to throw you off to the top of the cell, through the announce table, and I'm going to get a sledgehammer. I'm going to knock between your legs instead of your head, make more pain for you. I'm going to put you through the cell cage roof door. Hopefully, the canvas will break, and I'll try my best to do what takes it to edge and make the fire come up and burn you. Boom. That is all.
Mic drop.
That's an ECW promo right there.
Yeah. Man, but you can't see the fear in Daniel Bryan because of all the hair.
You can certainly see the piss running down his leg.
All right, Phoenix, are you ready?
Just about.
All right. Let's get a quick reminder then. Your match is an Iron Man match against Roman Reigns, who spilt paint thinner on your car.
Yeah, well, I can't.
Hang on a minute, hang on. Dolph Ziggler, you're a cunt.
All right.
Cunt.
Phoenix, pick up the mic.
Roman Reigns, you dare spill paint thinner on my car. And I don't give a fuck if it was an accident or not. Or I'm going to hunt you down, and I'm going to hurt you. I'm going to hurt you, bad boy. And you will never go near my car again. Get ready, bitch, because in an Iron Man match, the Rise of the Phoenix will continue.
All right, and those are the promos all done and dusted for another week. Whew. If you
there
think that was something.
Conspiracy against me, I know there is.
Well, hey, you might not catch a cut one next week. You need all the practice you can get now. Promo championship coming up. All right, that is the end of the show, but there is enough time for me to thank our captains, the Phoenix.
You're welcome.
Thank you. And Evan Money Makeba.
Hashtag Team Blood Red Money Pun is blood clot.
And of course, this week's guests on the blue team, Mike Chadwick.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming on. And our guest on the red team, of course, James Belmont.
Thank you for having me. Score one for the good guys. Team Money took it down today.
You can follow us on your Twitter machines, on Instagram, and like us on Facebook, all at Max Wrestling Mag. Me, myself, and I are at Epic Dazzy. You can find The Phoenix at...
ThePhoenix626.
Yes, you can. And you can find Evan Makeba at...
Push Makeba.
All right. And the guests, where can we find you this week? Who's going first?
Ladies first.
Oh, you can tell he's on the red team.
Yeah, find me on Facebook at Mike Chadwick.
That's it. There we go.
That's it.
And Mr. Belmont.
All right, if you're brave enough to follow me on that evil Twitter machine, you can follow me at JX2001, the official Offshoot Radio account at Offshoot Radio. And for some reason, I have Instagram, and that's JamesBelmont1882.
Yes, there we go. Don't forget this week's episodes of Sunday Segway on Offshoot Radio. Check out VOC Nation at vocnation.com. Follow The Swerve Talk for more details on our upcoming network. And also, don't forget SummerSlam tonight. UK listeners, get on Challenge TV at 9 tonight for TNA Impact using the hashtag...
ImpactUK.
And that is the bottom line.
Unfortunately, we're out of time.
Ta-ta for now.